Hi, everybody. Today is February 7th, 2013. For those of you who think that the police are out there protecting you from the bad guys, think again. Another reason you should be armed and skilled, taking classes on how to handle a gun. Miami-Dade cops caught on camera allegedly ignoring emergency calls. They sat on their asses, drinking their coffee on several emergency calls. They even said they were en route to one call. But the one that makes me the maddest was the call that they sat for 20 minutes of a 5-month-old baby not breathing. Now, if it was their baby, I bet you they would have responded, lights and sirens and etc. But no, they just sat there yakking, having their coffee. A group of Miami-Dade police officers was disciplined following a 2010 internal affairs investigation, police documents show. We're just now finding out about this. It's ongoing. You think it's, oh, that was in 2010. They got it all straightened out right. Five police officers and one sergeant with the Kendall squad were allegedly caught on camera ignoring emergency dispatch calls, plural. The video obtained by NBC 6 South Florida shows incidents like one October 5th, 2010, where officer, and I'm not going to try and pronounce it, apparently ignored a residential burglary call and chose to meet a woman at the Dadeland Mall parking lot. So instead of responding to the burglary call, he was out in the parking lot hugging and kissing on some woman. The video shows the officer hugging and kissing the woman in what police investigation calls a public display of affection. This is classified as departmental misconduct or conduct unbecoming an officer, according to the police. Well, what about not responding to the burglary? You got someone breaking into your house and the cops out there meeting a woman instead. I hope that resident had a gun, because the cop didn't show up. He was too busy hugging and kissing some woman. A little later, the same officer, along with another officer and the sergeant, Jennifer Gonzalez, were videotaped drinking coffee at a Casa Lares when an emergency call came in with an alert about an unconscious 5-year-old, police said in an investigation report obtained by NBC 6. The officer was dispatched to the scene, and despite being with his sergeant, he continued drinking his coffee. 9 minutes later, he was cleared from the call, according to police. Moments later, the dispatcher asked this officer to check out a Signal 37, or a suspicious vehicle. He said in a radio transmission that he was en route, but investigators said it took him 25 minutes to respond, and it shows on this videotape him saying he's en route as he drinks his coffee. At the end of the investigation, Sergeant Gonzalez and Officer Sakaris Huera, Ivan Thomas, Fabian Owens, and Jeffrey Price all received a relief of duty memorandum dated December 28, 2010. Officer Sakaris, who was also accused of doctoring reports to reflect that he had responded to calls, wrote a memo to his lieutenant saying that at no time did he intentionally violate department rules or regulations. Sakaris, Huerta, and Gonzalez have been fired by the Miami-Dade Police Department, according to the Internal Affairs Report. Several more officers have been disciplined, and some were expected to appeal their punishment. So they're still working. I guess it's a long process to fire a bad cop. Dade County Police Benevolent Association said it was waiting for disciplinary process to conclude before its comments. And Miami-Dade Police said it was not commenting on the investigation. I'll give you a link if you want to read more. 5-month-old baby unconscious, not breathing. A burglary in progress. And they're just too busy with their personal life while on duty. And they want to take our guns away. Alright, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.